All right, welcome back inside our Proactive Newsroom. And joining me now is Raul Sanabria. He is the president of Baroyeca Gold and Silver. And Raul, it's great to see you. How are you?
Yeah, hi, Steve. Good, and you?
I'm doing very well, thank you. And excited to learn a bit more about the company working in Colombia. Tell me a little bit about the company itself.
Well, Baroyeca is a publicly listed company. We're in the stock exchange, in the venture exchange, BGS is the symbol. We are part of the discovery group of companies since July of this year. And we have two assets in Colombia that were ingested since the private stage of the company. We've been holding to them for a number of years now, is the Atocha, which is in the core of the Santa Ana Colonial Primary Silver District, which is the highest grade silver district in Colombia, one of the highest in the world. And then we have the Santa Barbara Project. It's a gold project in Serranía San Lucas. By many, is the richest gold belt in Colombia. We are proving that by the all these very high grades that we're finding on channel samples and tunneling on the veins on the property.
Yeah, I want to ask you about both of those. Let's start with Atocha, because I know you had a recent drill program from there. And so maybe tell me a bit more about that project and what was the drill program looking at this year?
Well, we've been drilling Atocha for 1 year. So we've been testing like the northwesternmost corner of the property by axis. We have a large number of showings in excess of 1 kiloton silver equivalent, some of them with over 1 kiloton silver, actually. And this is in the core of the colonial district. We got all the Santa Ana colonial district to the north. We have the Frias colonial mine to the west. We had a few mines on the northern, like very close to the northern border of the property, and the Porvenir mine to the south. So we're all surrounded by these colonial mines, but the property hasn't been mined itself. So it's a grassroots project. All the veins were exposed and surfaced. And it was a conceptual target that we had from 10 years ago. So this is how long I've been working on that project, on that district. Our drilling at La Yeh, they proved the high grade grades. So we got over 2 kilos per ton silver equivalent in holes. And the first blend, 13 holes, we got several intersects per hole, and all of them average 0.5 kilo silver equivalent over 0.5 meter. Which is a very good start. And it's all at surface. We're not drilling under colonial mines. We're not drilling under any head frames. It's just from outcrop down. We have been moving that to the west into other showings. We proved the existence of the veins. In the west target, we got up to 900 grams per ton silver equivalent with several 400s, 500s, 600s, 700s. So we're still in the money with the 0.5 meter widths. We'll be all underground mining scenarios, obviously. And now we're thinking in moving the drill to Santa Barbara. We're being very, very frugal in expenses. We've been taking baby steps on our exploration. We haven't been very aggressive, but we know it's a district that is proven to be very, very rich. And we want to give an opportunity to the other project, to Santa Barbara, now with the rig.
Yeah, Santa Barbara is an interesting one because there's potential there for you to use some of that in order to help fund other exploration. Maybe you can kind of explain that one to us.
Yeah, the project on the private stage when Baroyeca acquired it, it had an exploration tunnel that went for over 100 meters, and it was organized as a bulk sample. It has a pilot processing plant that was custom built, and it replicates a lab, like crushing, milling, and homogenization. Same as you send a rock to the lab, when you do the crushing, the pulverizing, homogenization, you did the 50-gram scoop, and you put it into the assay, in the far assay. So we're doing the same. 10-ton batches into the plant, and we did 55 of them, roughly 500 tons, and it all came with an average 24 grams per ton. So translate that into kilos is over 10 kilos. At current $1,700 an ounce, we're looking at over $500,000 US net from that tunnel, from that bulk sample. So Baroyeca wants to do the same, and is getting one part of the properties. The Santa Barbara is comprised of two titles, and every title has a different stage. So it has different rules. So we're permitting where the plant is for a 50-ton operation so we can ramp up bulk sample. But in the meantime, we kept drifting exploratory tunnels. We have to remember there's a very thin line between bulk sampling and mining. So we want to make sure as a public company, that's what we slow down into the bulk sampling process and doing more underground development, channel sampling, proving the results, stockpiling rather than processing. But our veins are averaging 1 ounce per ton, roughly 1 ounce per 1 ounce per ton gold, which is very, very high grade over lengthy intervals. It's not nugget effect like in any projects. It's very evenly distributed. We did some metallurgical and poly sections, 50 micron particles. There's no coarse grain gold, but also avoids artisanal miners and legal miners to get into the property. It's very hard to extract, but conventional cyanide leaching at our plant, we got over 85-90% of recoveries with the bulk sample process, not even adding flotation or Merrill Crowe for pouring the gold. So it's or the concentrates in this case. So it's a very high grade project. Now we're doing the next steps to ramp up that bulk sampling out of 3-4 different parts of the vein or different veins. But at the same token, aggressively, we want to aggressively drill the property under those veins. And we can come up with a resource estimate fairly quickly if we do that way.
Okay. So what's the plan then for 2023? Is a lot of that work specifically?
Yes. We're in the middle of a financing right now. We announced $2 million at 10 cents with a 20 cent warrant, full warrant for 2 years. We announced it last month. So we're halfway through. So investors can participate. Qualified investors can participate. They have to contact me. But the use of proceeds initially is for a 1,500 to 2,000 meter program at Santa Barbara. Under the known maze, we can actually prove what we predicated from the beginning is the comparison to Buritica in that earlier stage, same host, same kind of veins, same grade, same consistency, same geology. So we want to prove that. And also we can look at other opportunities in Colombia. This company is leaving and we are actually offered a few packages we can look at. We're still very confident in the potential of Colombia. And while we speak, our exploration crews continue to map Atocha to generate additional high-grade targets. We don't want to go prospecting with the rig. That's what we're taking in the really baby steps. And get three more new drill-ready targets, high-grade, and go back after Santa Barbara and move the drill back. So those are initially our plans.
Yeah, it's going to be a busy one, that's for sure, it sounds like. Raul, thank you so much. Great to meet you and learn a bit more about the company. Good luck with everything, and we'll see what happens in 2023.
Yeah, thanks, Steve. Thanks for having me here today.
All right, there is Raul Sanabria. He's the president of Baroyeca Gold and Silver.